When should you be intimate with your partner compared to a positive ovulation test? That's the question for today's fertility Q&A. So if you want to find out the answer, then stay with me for the next few minutes. Hi, I'm Juliette Millar. I'm a trained natural fertility specialist with over 20 years experience. And welcome to today's Fertility Q&A, where I answer your quick questions on all things natural fertility. And if you want to see more videos like this one to get your fertility questions answered, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Today's question comes from Alicia, who asks, when should my significant other and I be intimate compared to when my OPK turns positive? I've read so many different things and now I'm totally confused. I love, love, love this question because there's so much incorrect information out there, even by so-called experts, and it's really easy to get this wrong. So to start with, a very quick review of why you would use an LH test or ovulation predictor kit in the first place. When you have a lovely mature egg in one of your ovaries that's fully developed and ready to be released at ovulation, your brain sends a surge of luteinizing hormone, or LH, to your ovaries. And it's this LH, or this LH surge, that triggers ovulation and causes the release of that egg from your ovary. So your LH surge will come first, and then you will ovulate. Most of the time. It is possible to get an LH surge and not ovulate, but that's a topic for another video. So an LH test or an ovulation predictor kit is designed to detect that LH surge and identify when you're about to ovulate. Now, if you're already using an ovulation predictor kit and you've followed the instruction sheet, you've probably been led to believe two things. Firstly, that ovulation will most likely occur within 24 to 48 hours after you see a positive result. And secondly, that this is when you are most fertile and that you want to be doing your baby dancing within those same 24 to 48 hours to get as close to ovulation as possible. So that sounds simple enough, right? Except that unfortunately, it's actually not quite that simple and not entirely correct. As you know, my goal with this channel is to give you accurate science-based information. And if you take a look at the science on this, you'll see that there's actually a bit more to the story. And that if you're following the guidelines on your OPK instruction sheet, unfortunately, you could be missing some or all of your fertile days and lowering your chance of getting pregnant. So let's look at some of the science on this and the actual facts. Firstly, the day that you ovulate is not your most fertile day. In fact, studies have found that the chances of getting pregnant are actually highest by having intercourse within the 2 to 3 days before ovulation day. And your most fertile day is actually determined by the type of cervical fluid you're producing, not how close to ovulation you are. Secondly, ovulation does not always occur 24 to 48 hours after you get a positive OPK result. A positive test just tells you that your LH surge has started, but it doesn't tell you exactly when ovulation is going to occur. Research has shown that ovulation can actually occur at the very beginning, during, at the end of, or after the LH surge. And when you consider that the LH surge itself can be anywhere from 1 to 5 days long, and sometimes much longer, this really starts to throw a spanner in the works. But basically, what this means is that when you get a positive LH test, you can't guarantee that you're going to ovulate in 1 to 2 days' time, even though most of the time this probably will be the case. But there's also the chance that when you get that positive LH test, you might have already just ovulated, or you might have just a handful of hours left before you do. And with ovulation day being a less fertile day compared with the 2 to 3 days beforehand, if you've waited until this point to be intimate, then unfortunately you'll probably have a lower chance of conception, or you might have missed the boat altogether. And conversely, if you assume that you're going to ovulate in 1 to 2 days' time and then stop having intercourse after that, But in actual fact, you end up ovulating 5 days later, which the research has shown can happen, then you could miss your most fertile days that way too. So what should you do? When should you be timing intercourse to conceive if you're using OPKs? Well, remember that the day of ovulation comes at the end of your fertile window, not the beginning. And as I mentioned before, it's also a less fertile day. So ideally, you want to start having intercourse in the few days before ovulation day, before your LH test turns positive, and then continue having intercourse every day or every second day until you ovulate. And how do you know when you've ovulated? Well, unfortunately, you won't know for sure unless you're taking your basal body temperature, which of course is one of the reasons that I highly recommend charting your fertility instead of or alongside using OPKs. And that way you can also use your cervical fluid to figure out your most fertile day or days each cycle. And again, research has shown that using cervical fluid is the most accurate way to find your most fertile day, more accurate than using an OPK. And of course, you can learn how to do this step by step in my Fast Track to Pregnancy program, which I'll link to below. And if you're interested in finding out more about the pros and cons of OPKs and why they can sometimes delay the time it takes to conceive, I'll also link to my free fertility guide on this topic below. So that's it for today. I hope you found that helpful. And if you've got a quick question that you'd like answered on getting pregnant naturally, just pop it in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer it in another Q&A video if I can. Bye for now.